My name is Rama Dharma. I am a senior consulting engineer here at Cumulus Networks.
In this video, we will be explaining how to configure OSPF unnumbered. The OSPF configuration has been optimized by Cumulus Linux, whereas the traditional old-school way of configuring OSPF required multiple IP addresses on multiple interfaces and each of those subnets to be advertised under the router OSPF sub-instance, which led to complex configurations of IP addresses and OSPF process numbers and unique information per node. Cumulus Linux has optimized OSPF to operate in a data center environment that is simple configuration, which is ideal for automating, and it only uses loopback addresses for all its configuration, which basically leads to no infrastructure IP addresses. The first part of OSPF unnumbered configuration is the IP address assignment. As you can see on the left, we have three unique IP addresses that need to be referenced in multiple places. On the right-hand side with OSPF unnumbered, you can see that we re-leverage the loopback address in all places, on the loopback, on the interface, as well as underneath the OSPF instance for the router ID and the network advertisement for peering. Another change to the OSPF unnumbered configuration is the application of the IP OSPF network point-to-point format underneath the interfaces that are actually peering OSPF unnumbered. In this example, we will be configuring OSPF unnumbered between a spine and a leaf. The spine on switch port 1 is connected to the leaf on switch port 51. We'll be applying the configuration to both the spine and the leaf to show how easy it is to configure OSPF unnumbered. First, we configure the loopback address on the spine. Next, we configure the same address onto the actual interface facing the leaf. After that, we set that interface facing the leaf to be a point-to-point OSPF network. And now we go into the OSPF subconfig and apply the router ID and advertise this loopback address as a network so we can peer on all interfaces assigned to that. Now that that is all completed, we can go ahead and commit these changes. Similarly, we can apply the same configuration to the actual leaf itself, except this time we're going to apply the configuration to the interfaces facing the spine. Now we commit those changes. With this configuration all applied, now we can check and see if the actual OSPF neighbor relationship is up. And as you can see, on both sides, OSPF has been built and established between the leaf and the spine using the loopback addresses applied to all the interfaces between the two. Here is the final configuration that has been applied to the spine and the leaf to build this OSPF neighbor relationship. Thank you for listening to this Cumulus video series.